Drishti IAS is pleased to bring your program Mastering Means Answer Writing. Targeting answer writing in civil services means examination. We will be alternatively covering GS papers 1, 2, and 3 through this program. For GS 4, please watch our program Ethics Definitions and Concepts. The link for it is mentioned in the description below. The structure of this program covers a GS question as basis for discussion, weightage of topic from which the question is being asked, how to approach the question, how to structure your answer, writing the actual answer, and related previous year's questions from the topic. Let's look at the question we'll be discussing in this episode. The question is, discuss the role played by NGOs in India and the challenges being faced by them. Also suggest probable measures that need to be taken to enable their better functioning. The question is on the topic Role of NGOs from the segment of governance under GS Paper 2. Over the period of 2013 to 2018, at least one question has been asked from this topic. Shifting towards how to approach the question. In general, there are two things we have to understand with respect to a question: the underlying theme of the question and what is being asked about that theme. Now let's consider the above question. The underlying theme of the above question is the role of NGOs. About this theme of NGOs, their role in India, challenges faced by them, and the measures needed to enable their better functioning have been asked. Another important step in framing your approach to answering any question is to understand the command word. The command word of this question, discuss, requires a broadly covered and an all-encompassing answer, highlighting both positive and negative aspects of the theme. Solutions and remedies can also be suggested. Moving towards how to structure the answer. The first part of the answer will be the introduction of the answer, which will include a brief description of NGOs. The second part of the answer, that is the body of the answer, will include the role of NGOs in India, various legislative and constitutional provisions, and the challenges faced by NGOs in India. Lastly, in our conclusion, we will sum up our answer by mentioning what measures can be taken to empower the NGOs. Shifting focus to actual answer writing. The answer provided here is a representative answer, that is, how the actual answer may look like. It can be adapted or modified as per your own natural style of writing, whether paragraph form or short sentences or bullets or diagrams. We have also taken certain liberties with the word limit by including certain additional information in the answer for your comprehensive understanding. Let's take a look at the answer. Introduction. Non-government organizations or NGOs are private organizations that pursue activities to relieve suffering, promote the interests of the poor, protect the environment, provide basic social services, or undertake community development. These organizations are generally non-state, not-for-profit, service-oriented groups working in public interest. The constitutional provisions for NGOs in India are in Article 19(1)(c) on the right to form associations, and Article 43, which states that the state shall endeavor to promote cooperatives in rural areas, to state a few. Over the years, NGOs have played a significant role in India. Body. Role in India. The contribution of NGOs in India has been diverse in areas such as social services, social advocacy, and development programs. Development. The state is no longer the only actor in formulating and implementing socio-economic development programs. NGOs play a key role in supplementing government efforts to bring about social equality, gender equality, and improving the general quality of life. They raise issues like poverty alleviation, child rights, caste stigma and discriminations, women rights, child labor, etc. For example, NGOs like Teach for India have made significant progress in providing quality education to the underprivileged children of our society. Social advocacy. NGOs play a vital role in mobilizing public attention to societal problems and issues. By giving voice to the underrepresented people and by integrating their perspectives into the mainstream social and political life, These organizations function as a kind of safety valve that helps strengthen participative democracy. They also facilitate transparency by continuously acting as an external check on government. Role in governance. NGOs enable government's accountability by ensuring that the government is responsive to citizens at large rather than to special sectarian interests. They induce innovation and flexibility in policy making through strategic collaboration. Role in policy making. NGOs that have domain expertise in certain areas help governments formulate better policies that are most effective. Role in policy implementation. Having a direct interface with public, NGOs through their grassroots network help government achieve last-mile impact of their policies. NGOs have the requisite experience and knowledge, making them a valuable partner in policy administration. Role in policy evaluation. Feedback from NGOs based on their monitoring and analysis of policies through social audits helps in establishing good governance. Several key legislations have been direct results of interventions by NGOs, like the Right to Education Act, MNREGA, and the Right to Information Act. NGOs enforce political accountability by regulating and monitoring government performance. Challenges faced by NGOs in India. Lack of an apex organization or a single law for governing the activities of NGOs in India makes accreditation a big challenge for NGOs, as it is very difficult to distinguish whether an organization wants to work for a cause or has been set up only for the purpose of receiving government grants. Multiplicity of rules and regulations hinders the operations of NGOs and adds burden of various compliances. This weakens our civil society. NGOs are often seen as encroaching on centuries-old tradition and culture of people, leading to mass protests at times. Ban on Jallikattu after the public interest litigation by PETA is one such example. Many NGOs have taken a hardline position against the government to an extent that all efforts of the government are hindered by these organizations. Such interventions often lead to policy paralysis, negatively impacting the development in the country. On the other hand, over-dependence on funds from the government dilutes the willingness of NGOs to speak out against the government. Thus, external checks on government accountability are diluted. Foreign funding of various NGOs has been revoked as a result of allegations that NGOs are being used as proxies to destabilize the law and order situation in the country. For example, in case of protests against the nuclear power plants. Way forward. Measures to augment NGOs. Home Ministry and Finance Ministry must resolve the confusion by bringing the regulation of NGOs under one head and enumerating guidelines for the accreditation of NGOs. Public confidence in the voluntary sector must be bolstered by introducing greater transparency and opening the sector to greater public scrutiny. Public donations are an important source of funds for the NGOs. Therefore, tax incentives must be designed in a manner that donations increase. NGOs strengthen community. Thus, the government and NGOs should work as partners and play complementary roles to achieve shared goals based on principles of mutual trust and respect. Let's look at the previous year's questions from this topic. In 2017, the questions asked were related to self-help groups. In 2016, the question asked was related to the people's participation in the governance system and the effectiveness of government system at various levels. In 2015, the question asked was related to the foreign funding of NGOs and the FCRA. The second question was related to the role of NGOs in India and how they can be strengthened. That is all for this episode. We will see you next time with a question from GS Paper 3. Stay tuned.